I'm sure it feels just good to get this win. Mm-hmm. What was the game plan coming in?
Game plan was, we talked about last year, and how sour of a taste that left in our mouth. And you know, we knew that coming in, we were playing a very good purchase line team. You know, take away what the game we had in December, that didn't mean anything. And we knew what we needed to do, and we wanted to jump out to an earlier lead, and we did, and control some things. But we know they're a very good second-half team. We talked about that at halftime. They've proved it all year, and then they come out in the second half and prove they're a second-half team. I think they scored 20-some points in the third quarter on us. I didn't see how many, but it was at least 25, I'm thinking. A lot. Too many.
Right. Is there anything you learned from that first matchup with them that you were able to use tonight, or has it been too long?
You know, we just know that they're athletic, and they're well-coached. They're a good basketball team, and we knew that they played us man-to-man last time. We thought maybe they'd play us a little zone tonight, but they went with the man-to-man for the most part. But they're athletic, and they can do that. And there was no surprises or anything. We just needed to play ball. And you know, they made some runs, but we made some runs back at them to get the lead back up. So, you know, kudos to the guys for doing that.
Obviously, you want your big players, your big-name players, to play well on the big stage and stuff like that. And Mike and Merrick tonight were just really great for you guys.
They were. Merrick was stepped up and was real strong tonight. He's had great games. He's had 36-point games. Michael gives up points to get points for other guys. But we have other guys that could do a lot of things, too. And you know, Jackson Lubbig made some big threes for us. And Jake Andrews come off the bench and just gave us some valuable minutes. And that's a kid that started last time against the purchase line. And he's reduced his role, and he's accepted it. And he's a great kid and just come in and did whatever he was asked to do. And that's what team's about. That's what being a part of a team's about. He did a great job.
When did you guys figure out that Jackson Lubbig was going to be able to play tonight if they both started?
That's a funny thing. I found out last night in practice. I walked into practice. I get there a little bit late because of work, coming from school. I walked in, and he's practicing. And I said, "You kidding me?" He was in an air cast and crutches the last time I talked to him.
Right.
He went to the doctor, and he said, "Oh, great, he was cleared." I just asked him. I told him a phone call would have been nice because I had talked to reporters and said he was in crutches, and it
right.
made me look a little bit, you know, I was glad to have him. He ended up starting tonight because Aaron Tatino was a little bit down in the weather. So,
how's playing a good team like this on a big stage, everything like that, help you go into playoffs?
First of all, this is amazing. 3,000 fans. I mean, you don't get that in the playoffs, but it's a playoff atmosphere, and you know, we knew going in how special this place is, and it gets you ready for the playoffs. You know, your fans come to the games, and they'll travel. And we should have a home playoff game for sure, and maybe two even. I don't know, but it was exciting, and it leads us right to the playoffs. We have a game with Homer next week, a makeup game. That'll be a good game because we don't have any games next week, so playoffs don't start the following week. So that'll be a nice matchup for us.
Mm-hmm. So you come back here and you kind of avenge the loss from last year here. And then did you guys talk about the loss in the playoffs last year and how you guys want to kind of avenge that loss too?
Yeah, we did. I mean, the moment we walked off this court last year, the goal was to get right back here and do this again, which we knew it was going to be difficult to do. Losing that playoff game right after that, I think that settled in. We lost this game. We were kind of down on ourselves, and we didn't win the playoff game. We played a good Bellwood Annis team, but we didn't play well. And I think part of that was because we were still messed up from this game. But it was a great win. We finally got something on that banner out at Ligonier. It's been a long – there's nothing on that banner. There's finally something on the banner. So that's all we've been talking about. So we're excited.
This was the goal for everybody to get here and play in this game. Now you win the conference. Bigger goals for this team. Have you guys talked about them, and what are they?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, moving on to districts and winning the district title. And there's a lot of great teams in AAA District 6, so it's going to be very tough. But, you know, we got knocked out in the second round last year. We got a bye in the second round, but, you know, we want to go as far as we can. We want to qualify for the state playoffs and just see how far we can go.
All right, Todd, sounds good.
Thank you.